Well, the Word of God is so wonderful for each of us, really. It's amazing. And this Gospel of St. Mark is really the first Gospel in it. And the story they tell of Jesus turning to the apostles, and they ask him the question, where are we going to celebrate the Passover? So where are we going to celebrate the angel of death passing over the community of the Israelites? Where are we going to celebrate that? And he turns to them and he says, go into Jerusalem and you're going to find a guy carrying a water jug. Follow him. You got to be kidding me. I mean, it's amazing. It really is. And they had spent so much time with him that they trusted him. They trusted him that much that they were willing to go to Jerusalem and follow the guy with the water jar. Now, how did they know they were going to end up in the water wash? I mean, but they trusted him. They were open to him. They had faith in him. And so in many ways, that really describes us right now as we've entered this cathedral together as a people of God. And we come with a spirit of trust. We've come with a spirit of openness. And we've come because of his word to us. He has asked us to be here in this upper room. And lovely as it is, God's grace has blessed us with a wonderful cathedral. This is where we celebrate the Passover. Awesome. This is where we celebrate the angel of death, or the angel of sin, passing over each and every one of us. And as we enter into this moment, this Eucharist, around this table of the Lord, this altar, it is truly a moment for us to celebrate the love of God in our lives. And he meets us where we are. That's the other key point of this. He meets us where we are. So if we're married or single, we're divorced, whatever, he meets us where we are. If we're older, younger, little baby pixies, he meets us. And he wants to meet us with his love. And he says to us, I want to celebrate a meal with you. And it's not just any meal. I want to celebrate a meal of heaven with you. I want you to be touched by the grace of heaven, by the gift of heaven, by the power of heaven. And that's what we do. It is a powerful moment for us to be graced by the Lord Jesus Christ. You know, we heard in the scriptures that Moses offered blood of the young bulls to the Lord, and he sprinkled the people with the blood. When he did that, they were forgiven, but they were also entering into the covenant with God, that God would be faithful to them, and they would be faithful to God. This is the new covenant that we celebrate at this altar. And it is the blood of Jesus Christ that enables us to truly know we are forgiven. And we are forgiven by the love of God. God giving us his Son. God loving us that much that he's willing to reach into our lives and say, it doesn't matter what you did. I forgive you because I died on the cross for you, and I'm calling you to be with me forever in heaven. That's what this is about. It's about heaven. It's about sharing God's life in heaven. And that's why he gave us his body and blood. The scriptures tell us, he said to his disciples, take this. Take it, the bread. It is my body. He didn't say, it may be my body, it might be my body, it could be my body. He said, it is my body. Wow. He's giving us himself. And then he said, with the wine, take this. This is the blood of the new covenant. It's like Moses sprinkling us with the blood of the bulls. But more. His blood offered for us, offered for the many, he said in the gospel. That's the gift of his life and his love that he gives to each of us. So as we approach the altar to receive Holy Communion and the minister proclaims the body of Christ, we say, Amen! Yes, let it be so in my life. Is everybody awake? I hope by now. It is the love of Christ that we celebrate. That's what the Feast of Corpus Christi is all about. It's about heaven. We touch heaven when we receive this body. And he becomes a part of us, and we become a part of him. Thus, we are the body of Christ together. Let's pray the Eucharist with that special grace.